Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at how to add subtitle tracks to your videos. So the goal here is not actually to imprint text at the bottom of a video. You could do that adding a lower third title in either Final Cut Pro or iMovie. I'm talking about how to add an actual subtitle track. If you go to View, Subtitles, you actually see a subtitle track here like English. And you'll also be able to see this track on iOS devices, Apple TV, and various other places. Let's see how we can add that to our videos. So you'd think you'd be able to do something like this with iMovie, Final Cut Pro, maybe even the QuickTime Player. But in fact you can't. All you can do there is to put lower third titles and put them across the whole video, painstakingly making each one, which can get really tedious for a long video. And then they're permanently on there. So you can't have, say, English, French, and Spanish, or the ability to turn it off. It's just a permanent part of the video. So we're going to use an app called iSubtitle. And I found this in the Mac App Store. There are various different ones, but this one does the trick. And we're going to drag and drop this video to it. And we'll open it up in there. And you can see here I've got the video open here and I have a sidebar here on the right that has various information about the video including subtitles for which there are none. Now one of the things this software does is if you've say ripped a video from DVD and you want to apply special subtitles to it in a language of your choice, it'll search the web for them. But we're not doing that here. We're looking at our home movies or maybe professional videos we're making for work and how to add subtitles. So we're going to not use any of the built-in functions to search the internet for subtitles, but actually create our own subtitle file. So to create a subtitle file, we're going to go to Text Edit and we're going to create a new document and make sure it's set to plain text format, which we know it is because we have the ability to make it rich text. And I'm going to put in here the subtitles. I actually have copied it into the buffer. I'm going to paste it in. And you can see what these look like. They all start with a number of the subtitle and then from and to times here in hours, minutes, seconds, and milliseconds. And you need the colons there. You need them to be two digits. You need this to be three digits. You need the comma. And then you need the spacing and the appropriate characters in between. You can see here. It's pretty simple basic text stuff, but you got to get it just right or it won't work. Then you have the actual text you want to appear. And you can even have more than one line of text. And whatever playback device you've got, whether it's the QuickTime Player or Apple TV, whatever it is, we'll figure out how to appropriately display this stuff. And then when you've got that all done, you want to save it. And we want to save it in what's called an SRT file. So an SRT file is basically a text file that has this data in it, but we want to make sure we're putting the right file extension. And we're going to pay careful attention to the text encoding here because we're going to need to know that when we actually use this in iSubtitle. So I've got subtitles.srt ready to go now. I'm going to go back into iSubtitle here and I'm going to hit the plus button, not do drag and drop because the plus button will allow me to make sure I can choose the encoding. I don't want to leave it at guess because it may guess wrong and think it's supposed to be Windows encoded text. I want to make sure it's UTF-8 like when I saved it. I'm going to go here and I'm going to open up that file and now it appears here and if I were to scrub back and forth I can see the subtitles generated by iSubtitle. So they're going to look slightly different when they're generated by QuickTime or something else and they're in the proper places. So now all I need to do is save. And I'll do a save as and I will save to that same folder and I'll call it fireworks sub rather than, there we go, fireworks sub MOV. So now I can see I've got two different versions in here, both the same because the text isn't going to take up much space, but this one's the new one that I've added the subtitles to. Now if I were to double click on this, it's going to open up in QuickTime Player and when I run it, I'm going to see I'm not going to get any subtitles because I haven't selected any subtitles up here. Remember at the beginning when I went to subtitles there was nothing. Now there's something there. I'm going to select English and I can see now that the subtitles will appear and you can see how they do look a little bit different because QuickTime Player is rendering them in a different way. And it will render it in a different way in whatever software you're using. You want it to actually render it in the way that it feels appropriate for whatever the playback device or software is. So now I've added that. I could have added more than one track to there and then I would be able to see English, French, Spanish, whatever underneath here.